You're in the pitch black in the middle of the ocean twilight zone. The sublights come on, and what you see looks like a blizzard of snow. When you look even closer, there are tiny microscopic plankton jumping from one particle to another.
The great age of exploration didn't end in the 1800s, it's continuing. And the Twilight Zone is that next frontier.
The Twilight Zone is this vast realm of the ocean below the sunlit surface layers, down about 1,000 meters.
And it's about half a mile thick, like two Empire State Buildings stacked on top of one another. It extends around two-thirds of our globe.
It's deep, it's dark, it's corrosive.
We started out thinking of it as one layer, and we're now realizing there are many layers within layers. It's a very structured and complex habitat.
The mysterious, high-pressure, low-temperature environment. We used to think of the ocean twilight zone as something of a desert, and we weren't aware of all the incredible biomass and biodiversity.
The fish have adaptations that are hard to believe. Cool critters with their big teeth and their lights on their bellies and their lights under their eyes.
There's amazing stuff there that we don't understand.
The more we learn about the ocean twilight zone, the more important we are finding it seems to be for the whole ocean ecosystem.
Any open ocean organism is relying heavily on the ocean twilight zone. Things that we eat ourselves, tuna, sharks, big top predators in the ocean, they all feed on these little critters.
The animals that live in the twilight zone play a major role in regulating our planet's climate.
We took all of the marine life out of the twilight zone, that would have huge impacts on the ocean's ability to sequester carbon. Whether you're living inland or you're seeing the effects of sea level rise, if you're in the interior, that will affect all of us.
It will be a critical piece of how humans both sustain and thrive in the following century.
The opportunity that we have in exploring the Twilight Zone is really exceptional for humanity to understand a new frontier.
Because this area of the ocean is so undersampled, the potential for discovery is enormous.
There might be 10 times or perhaps even 100 times of the biomass than we thought previously. And if these numbers are correct, that completely changes the way that we view the functioning of the entire ocean.
We're only just learning how important the Twilight Zone is. Getting to those answers, getting to those fine details of how the Twilight Zone fits into the bigger picture of the planet is a phenomenal undertaking.
The ocean twilight zone is a huge habitat. We know almost nothing about it because it's extremely difficult to study. A place like the Woods Hole Oceanographic Institution is poised to change that because we have experienced engineers who know how to build the technologies that help us to overcome the incredible challenges.
New tools coming online, new ways of observing, new technologies, new sensors, autonomous underwater vehicles, it can be ocean observatories.
Robots to go down and find these critters in their natural habitat
could really be a game changer, revolutionize our ability to study the Twilight Zone.
We have so many things yet to learn. We need answers to these important questions quickly.
We don't know enough about the ocean twilight zone to be able to see the impact that we're having on it yet.
Now's the time where we could make wise decisions that would prevent a future disaster.
We're really beginning to accelerate the speed of discovery. The stakes could not be higher. We have an opportunity here to do things differently right now.